ثم تطلع. ايوه تمام. الله يجزيك.
جزاك الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاه والسلام على رسول الله وعلى اله وصحبه ومن والاه. It was reported, narrated in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. So it's called Muttafaqun Alayhi, one of the highest degree of authenticity in Islam. Prophet Muhammad SAW says that Jibreel alayhi salam came to him and he said, Ya Muhammad, هذه خديجة قد أقبلت إليك ومعها وعاء فيه طعام. فأقرئها من ربها ومني السلام وبشرها ببيت في الجنة من قصب لا مصب فيه ولا تعب. حديث was narrated by Bukhari and Muslim. Highest authenticity. It says that Jibreel alayhi salam came to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and he said, O Muhammad, in a moment Khadija is approaching, she's coming to you. She's holding some kind of food with her. So when she comes, tell her that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending the salam specifically to her, and I, Jibreel, is sending the salam as well to her. Look, the first amazing thing, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel with a special revelation just to send the salam to Khadija. And Jibreel alayhi salam himself was asking Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say the salam to Khadija. Then he continued, قال وبشرها, give her the glad tidings, the good news, ببيت في الجنة, أو بقصب في الجنة, with a palace, a house in the Jannah. قال من قصب, it was made completely out of pearls, you know, from the jewels. لؤلؤ, قصب لؤلؤ, out of pearls, completely. قال لا نصب فيه ولا تعب, which means there's no illness, no tiredness, no sadness, nothing that you hate, which means she will be dwelled completely in the Jannah. It's like the, like Tabshir bil Jannah. Now, the amazing part. Why Khadija deserves this status? Here comes the question. Do you think it's just خلاص because Allah decided يعني to send, you know, by the way, to the best of my knowledge, Jibreel in this incident, he was sent just to send this message at that moment, which means he did not come with something from the Quran or something else, plus in addition to, by the way, he said, no, he was sent specifically to send salam to Khadija. Wow, it's amazing, can you imagine? She's a human being, she's not a prophet. She's a normal human being. We can realize this from another hadith narrated by Bukhari. We understand the hadith by another حديث. عائشة is the narrator now. عائشة says, ما كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يترك البيت إلا ويذكر خديجة ويحسن الثناء عليها. It was part of the habit of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم that he used not to leave the house, but by leaving the house he used to mention خديجة and he used to praise her and to ask forgiveness for her. قال فأخذتني الغيرة يوما. Said once a day I felt very jealous. I could not stand. فقلت له يا رسول الله أو ما زلت تذكر تلك العجوز وقد أبدلك الله خيرا منها. يا رسول الله. Now عائشة, she's the speaker now. She said, يا رسول الله, still you are remember that old woman. She did not even call her with her name. She said, old woman, عجوز. قال, even Allah سبحانه وتعالى has given you who's better than her. She was talking about her. رضي الله عنها. She was very frank with him, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now look to the reply of Prophet Muhammad. From the reply we understand why Khadija deserved that status. He said, لا والله ما أبدلني الله خيرا منها. He said, no, by Allah, Allah has not replaced me with a better than her. She was the best. Look, now the justification, it's not a philosophy. It's a practical application. If you want to deserve a status in the sight of Allah, you have to do an action. It's not just a wishful thinking. Number one, قال آمنت بي حين كفر الناس. She believed in my da'wah when everyone did kufr against me. قال وصدقتني حين كذبني الناس. She believed in me when everyone was saying that I'm a liar. قال ووسطني بمالها. She supported me with her money ورزقني الله منها الولد, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى gave me the offspring, you know, Fatima, أم كلثوم, وزينب, وإبراهيم, والقاسم, all of them, they are from, sorry, إبراهيم, جزاك الله خير, القاسم, جزاك الله خير, القاسم, from خديجة رضي الله عنها, passed away طبعا, القاسم when he was young. ورزقني الله منها الولد, اللهم ارحم خديجة, اللهم ارضى عن خديجة, اللهم ارحم خديجة, اللهم ارضى عن خديجة. قالت عائشة, فآليت على نفسي ألا آتي على ذكرها أبدا. عائشة said, I decided that never ever in my life I will mention خديجة. خلاص, close with her. My point, sorry I took your time, I will ask you anything. My point, خديجة deserved this with something she did, not something she wished, something she did. To a degree, Allah sent the ark of the angels, زعيم الملائكة, to send the salam for her. By the way, any one of us can reach this status. In Islam, it's not impossible, but you have to pay the tax first. What's the tax? Faith, belief, action with sincerity. Very simple. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to let every one of you, inshallah, to be like Khadija, inshallah, bin Allah, and to be from the people of the Jannah, bin Allah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa ahlul azza, azam Allah wa ajalakum. InshaAllah. We have our brothers here, they have, we are just paying the condolence for them. The brother here, I think is...
Iyad
Marzouk. Brother of us, his name is Iyad Marzouk, passed away, and they have the, you know, they received the condolence here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descend his mercy upon him. Azam Allah wa ajalakum. InshaAllah. Wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.